Today on the BV3D channel, we've got a quick update on the Elegoo Centauri Carbon with fixes for some of the problems I showed previously, a couple of new issues, and fixes for those as well. And we'll get into it right after this. I'm Brian, and you are watching BV3D. Hello, 3D printing friends, and welcome back. Okay, so we're back with the Elegoo Centauri Carbon. We've got a couple of new issues, a fix for one of them, tips on dealing with the other one, and fixes for previous problems. Please use those chapter markers on the video's timeline if you want to jump around from one section to the next. Okay, here we go. So first, let me bring up some of the issues from the previous video. One really big problem I had was a breakdown in communication between the slicer and the printer. I had only been able to send a couple of print jobs from the slicer directly to the printer over Wi-Fi before that feature stopped working, and the couple of times that it did work, it turned off the printer's time-lapse feature. And most of the time when it failed to work, the printer would quit talking to the slicer altogether. So I had to print the old-fashioned way, saving files to a flash drive and moving that over to the printer to start a print from the touchscreen. It worked, but it wasn't super convenient. Well, Elegoo fixed that with an update to the slicer, which came out the day I wrapped recording and started editing the previous video. And since I was tied up for a couple of days with editing, I didn't notice it. Shout out to Uncle Jesse for pointing it out in the comments. So, the new version of Elegoo Slicer, version 1.1.7.3, resolved about 90% of the issues I was running into with the slicer and the printer not playing nicely with each other. Now I can send a print job from the slicer over Wi-Fi and it gets to the printer correctly every time. It even fixed the problem with the time-lapse feature getting turned off, as well as a problem where you couldn't tell the printer which side of the flex plate you were printing on. Now all those settings are presented as checkboxes in the slicer right before the file gets sent over to the printer. Now, there hasn't been a firmware update yet, so some issues on the printer still persist. For one, camera streaming is still hit or miss. For another, in the printer's web interface, the thing you see in the slicer's device tab for the printer, the graphics with the Chinese characters still need to be updated to display in the language selected on the printer. But with this update, Elegoo seems committed to fixing these issues, so their slicer makes the cut. And that makes me happy. Next, let's cover the bed. I noticed this issue shortly after releasing the previous video. When starting a print job, the bed would start heating, but it wasn't up to temperature by the time the printer started printing. In some cases, it was still 20 degrees cooler than the temperature it was supposed to be at, but this was something I was able to fix easily. In the slicer, I looked at the starting G-code for the printer. What I found was that Elegoo was using the M140 command to set the bed temperature. Why is that a problem? Well, because when the M140 command sets the bed temperature, the printer is free to continue processing the rest of the G-code commands, including printing the model. M140 doesn't wait for the bed to get up to temperature. But here's the simple fix. Change the M140 to M190. The M190 command sets the bed temperature and tells the printer to wait for the bed to get up to that temperature before processing the rest of the commands. So change that M140 to M190 and save the printer, and from that point on, anything you slice and print will wait for the bed to get up to temperature before printing. I've let Elegoo know about it, so I'm hoping they roll that into another slicer update. One last problem with a workaround. The filament path has a tight turn right as it gets to the toolhead, and I've noticed that sometimes it can be pretty hard to get the filament to make it through that bend when I'm loading it. So if getting the filament loaded is sending you around the bend, there are a couple of things you can try. One, using flush cutters, try to snip a cone-shaped point on the tip of it. That can help it navigate the filament path. The other thing you can try is removing the glass top and manually smoothing out the filament path where it curves. Try to make the bend a little less sharp, and that should help the filament get down into the extruder where it needs to go. So that's it. That's the video, short and sweet. Big thanks to everyone who supports the channel, whether with channel memberships or by using the links in the description. If you liked this episode, give it a thumbs up and maybe subscribe so you don't miss new ones. Well, 3D printing friends, that's about all the time we have for this one. And now that we're at the end, let's go print something cool.